Gon and Killua used the Accompany they took out of the Greed Island game to transport to the player named Nigg. They both appear in a quite foggy-like environment with a figure leaning against a tree, fishing. Gon takes a step towards the mysterious person, but his footstep alerts them to their presence. He drops his fishing rod and assaults both Gon and Killua. He then uses his nan ability, Crazy Slots. He draws a gun and opens fire at Gon. Killua quickly dives to pull Gon out of the way. Killua notices an injured ant on the ground. The figure quickly explains that he was preventing them from being attacked, and that the ant he shot was actually a Chimera ant, an aggressive insect currently under a Class 1 quarantine. The injured ant attacks Killua and Kite quickly kills it. The man reveals that they were actually standing next to a Chimera ant's nest, and if he hadn't intervened, a whole ant army would have attacked them. Gon says that this person isn't Jin, but is actually someone he met on Whale Island before he set out to be a hunter. The man is revealed to be Kite, a student of Jin's. Sitting around a campfire, Kite begins to tell his story about how he met Jin and how he managed to track him down. Kite tells them how he used to be a thief and would steal bread with the aid of some animals. When he returned to his hideout in the sewers, he found Jin there. Kite asked Jin to train him and soon developed his own men. Jin told Kite to try and catch him if he can. The journey Kite went on to find Jin was long and hard. On his journey, he traveled to Whale Island in order to find clues to Jin's whereabouts. When he finally finds him, Jin says that the boy he saved on Whale Island was Gon, his son. Kite suspects that Jin has set it all up. Gon agrees and explains how Jin set up the fight with Razor. Gon asks if Kite had ever been to Greed Island, and Kite confirms he was taken into the game but wasn't sure if he used the alias Nigg. It then becomes apparent that Jin asked Elena to make the Accompany card. If used, take Gon to Kite, and magnetic force, take him to himself. His reasons being he doesn't want Gon with friends when he first meets him. When Kite asks whether Gon wants to know his father's current whereabouts, he refuses as he wants to find Jin without cheating. Kite tells Gon that his father is capable of being a triple star hunter, but remains a double star because he's uninterested in the paperwork. Meanwhile, we see a mysterious creature in a cave eating fish, trying to recover her strength. She is the queen, and she must give birth to the king. The Chimera Ant Queen eats in the cave, already planning the birth of the king. The next morning, Gon and Killua talk with Kite. He tells them he is a biological surveyor of new species and about the camp tiger. This animal uses the horn on its head to pierce through its food and cook it over a fire. Killua asks about the Chimera ants, and Kite tells him they're class 1, a very dangerous insect. He was studying the anthill until he had to kill them all. Just then, Kite's partners stick dinner, Banana Cavaro, Spinner Clo, and Montanures head toward the group. They are amateur hunters in the same field as Kite. They introduce themselves, and Spinner recognizes Gon's last name as the same as Jin's. They also recognize Killua's surname Zoldyck for the assassin family. Learning the two boys are also pro hunters, the group is even more shocked. They say they've been with Kite for 3 years, and Lin Koshi and Podongo Lapoy are two other surveyors in the group. Monta shows Kite a Chimera Ant Queen claw, which is abnormally big. Kite doesn't know why it's so large, but is obviously worried. It was found on the Asian continent, and a researcher named Wong told them about the new ant species. He hired them to find more information as they need a hunter to identify it. The surveyors walked into a vault and under glass found an insect arm as big as a human's. This is where they got the sample to study from. Kite brings the boys along to the south of Your New City where the ant arm was found. While walking, Kite sees the similarities between Gon and Jin, smiling at the thought of his friend. He thinks Gon will find Jin soon. Back at the cave, the queen eats a bat but needs bigger prey. The group is now driving to the new location. They discuss further why the ant grew as big as it did. Banana thinks it has something to do with the way they reproduce, phagogenesis, which is the process of eating an organism, giving birth, and the next generation gaining its abilities. An ant can lay up to 5 eggs at a time, so the generations could grow larger with each new metamorphosis. Killua figures by the size of the claw, the ant could be more than 6 feet tall and easily able to eat a human. In the woods, a boy named Kurt protects his sister Rihanna from a snake. Later, they're home with their mother, Haruna, and have dinner. He promises to keep them both safe from harm. At the same time, the queen looks over her eggs, now more than a few dozen hanging from the ceiling of the cave. The soldiers hatch in the form of a bat, fish, crab, etc. She telepathically orders them to find new food so she can give birth to the king. Now morning, Rihanna and Kurt have caught a lot of fish and head home. Suddenly, a crab ant comes out of nowhere. Kurt tries to attack it, but it's no use. The queen eats, happy about this new food. Kurt and Rihanna's clothes lay by her feet. She wants more. The surveyors and the boys make it to the beach. They scout out the area, wondering if it went into the forest. Banana uses her dog to find out where the queen might have gone. Gon also joins in. They don't find anything, and Kite suggests they look around other nearby shores. They split up and spend all day searching, but with no luck. Meanwhile, a new ant is born, this one more human-looking than others. The queen orders him to take the ant army and bring her more human food. Chimera ants are class 1 quarantine carnivorous insects. Once they have grown beyond 2 meters in length, humans do not stand a chance against them. While working the fields, a man in a village sights a swarm approaching. Befuddled, he asks what it is. When they finally see the chimera ants descending on them, the villagers run away in terror. Colt commands the soldiers to capture only the fully grown individuals, since they provide more nutrition. After capturing plenty of villagers, Colt and his underlings fly back to the queen. We later learn that chimera ant queens move around until they find a place they like. At that point, they birth more and more ants to form an army, and then carpenter ants to build a nest at incredible speed. The queen will remain in the nest until her death. Assuming one grew to 2 meters and began to target humans, there should be entire towns missing. However, Spinnera, the computer in a hotel room, informs Kite, Gon, and Killua that she cannot find anything, and in 6 months, the largest group of missing people number 10. Gon inquires whether it is possible to look up single people individually, but she replies that there are way too many. She tries to check which areas have the highest concentration of missing people, but the data is 2 years old. Gon and Killua suggest they search for sightings again to no avail. Banana begins to suspect they are getting worked up over nothing, to which Spinnera agrees. However, Kite asks her to bring up the tidal data from the day the arm was found. She does so, and Kite tells her to go back 10 days to locate any currents that might have carried it in that time, as he believes it could have been severed when the ant made landfall. Spinnera says it might come from the Balsa Islands, including the Mighty Union, where Angiel is located. Aside from Angiel, there is also the Republic of East Gorto, and there is no getting any sort of information out of those two countries. Killua asks what is Angiel, and Banana replies it is an acronym standing for Neo Green Life. It is a country founded by people who wanted to live in the nature. Bringing machinery into its borders is a crime, and according to Spinnera, when in 82 three journalists attempted to trespass, one of them was sentenced to death and the others are still in jail. The amateur hunters wonder what NGL people would do if they were to come in contact with the chimera ants, and Kite replies they would probably do nothing, as they let epidemics run their course rather than letting international doctors in. And even if they tried to spread the news, the underdeveloped means of transport and communication would make it impossible for them to succeed before it is too late. If that arm belonged to a queen, she might have already constructed her nest. Later we see Pockle and Ponzu, who are on an expedition to infiltrate NGL. Pockle is a beast hunter, which makes him an excellent candidate for the job. Ponzu opts to tag along since her ability will be highly useful for this mission. Gon and Killua decide to join Kite on his mission. He tells them that they are responsible for protecting themselves. He also tells them that if it's him who needs protection, they must leave him. They set off on their journey on a flying blimp. The Chimera Ants soldiers have amassed a large quantity of humans from the neighboring villages. This has allowed the queen to breed stronger and more powerful humanoid Chimera Ants. Peggy is one of those ants. He possesses a high IQ and functions as a librarian, providing details about the human world. Alligator, one of the more aggressive ants, challenges Colt to capture more humans than him. His assertive behavior prompts Colt to remind him that he follows only orders issued by the queen. The queen sends a remote signal to all of her elite soldiers, commanding them to assemble. These Chimera ants are squad leaders, each responsible for leading campaigns to capture humans for the queen. The queen tells them that she is preparing for the birth of the king and requires more food. Her soldiers must provide 50 humans for her. Deep in her nest, the queen gazes upon 3 of her eggs. They are to become the king's royal guards. She says that she will give names to them. Kite and the crew drive through the desert on their way to NGL. At the same time, Pockle and his crew ride to NGL on horseback. Back in the Chimera Ants' nest, Peggy briefs the soldiers on neighboring villages where they can find more humans. Chidu expresses his excitement about the hunt. He says he wishes there were stronger humans so that he could chase them around. Colt says to the group that they need only capture the exact amount of humans the queen requested. Zazen agrees with Chidu, stating that she prefers to do things her way and that hunting humans as they run is fun. Colt is annoyed with both Zazen and Chidu for their insubordination. He believes that too much individuality will break down the command. In the woods, a group of men are seen running away from something. Yunju is revealed as the pursuer. He and his squad enjoy the hunt. Kite, Gon, and Killua arrive at the NGL border, which sits inside a giant tree. Two men meet them at the entrance and state that because they are professional hunters, they cannot deny them entry. Inside the tree, the men state that no metals or machines are allowed in NGL. This strict rule reduces Kite's crew to only 5 people. After a strict examination, they are given passage into NGL. Colt and his squad carry humans from a village. He spots Ramit carrying a boy into the woods. Colt tells Ramit to be more selective, and that they have already met their quota for the day, but Ramit says that he will just eat the human himself. Colt orders him to put the boy down. Ramit frustratingly tosses the boy into nearby bushes. Pockle and his crew find a body in the woods. After examining the wounds, he says that his crew won't be able to handle the monsters who attacked the body. Just then, they are approached by a group of Chimera ants. Pockle activates his Nen ability, Red Arrow, and eliminates the ants. Yumju and his crew infiltrate an NGL underground cave. They are met with resistance but are unfazed and eliminate everyone in their path. The country's shadow ruler is cornered. Gyro in his childhood experienced many abuses from his drunk father. Getting beaten, learning to sleep without any emotions or movement in fear of making a sound in bed that might wake his father, even learning to control his bladder at night. Even so, he still saw his father as a god from the lesson, "Don't make trouble for others," and Gyro took by that advice. No matter how cruel his father would be, he continued to idolize him for two reasons. When Gyro was 5, he got a fever that almost killed him, but his father stayed all night taking care of him, and his father never asked or ordered him to leave from their home. However, Gyro's feelings towards his father changed when a guy from his work revealed that the only reason his father let him stay was because he brought money and his neighbor was the one who actually took care of him when he was sick. His father did nothing. Gyro snapped after hearing the truth and attacked the guy, but was badly beaten. Bloody on the ground, his father glanced at him while walking by and never helped him. He now knew his father never cared for him and the lessons he taught were for his own benefits. He realized that the world never gave him a single thing. He stood up, grabbed a hammer, and killed his father. 9 years later, Gyro founded and ruled NGL to ruin life by distributing drug D2. In the present, Yunju's team has killed Gyro's soldiers and took over the hidden drug factory. The situation in NGL is getting worse as the Chimera ants continue to kill humans on their own accord, while Pockle's team watches on helplessly. After learning about soldier ants killed by guns from Chitu, Colt collects information from Peggy by examining the corpse. It is revealed to him that some humans possess special abilities that the Chimera ants don't, but he believes they can easily learn what humans can. Peggy explains the human strength of learning and knows if they find out the queen makes them vulnerable, humans will do everything to kill her. Colt gets furious and warns Peggy that they will do everything to protect their queen. He tells Peggy that they will protect Reina, but can't remember who that is. Meanwhile, Pockle and his group can't send any messages to other hunters about the situation, so they decide to leave NGO, but a group of Chimera ants attack them. After one of his colleagues is killed, Pockle manages to kill a Chimera ant by using his Nen, but a spider-like Chimera ant comes for him. Pockle fires another arrow, but it is easily caught by his opponent who knows about Nen techniques. He attacks Pockle, who manages to dodge, but Balda gets caught in the spider web, is pulled and instantly killed when Pike bites off his head. This angers Pockle, who attacks the ant by punching him multiple times. When he's about to do a finishing blow, Pockle suddenly faints from getting stung by Zazen's tail. Zazen orders Pockle's body to the queen, believing he has the nutrients of 1,000 humans. Ponzu, who was in Pockle's team, manages to escape and uses her bees to send a message to any nearby hunters for help. Ponzu keeps running for her life, but is suddenly shot down by a gun-toting ant who shoots her multiple times and eats her body. Kite, Gon, and Killua receive the message from Ponzu, and Kite asks if Gon and Killua will join him even if it is dangerous. Before going any further, Kite asks Stick and Podongo to leave NGL and contact the Hunter Association about the situation in NGL. Kite, Gon, and Killua race to their destination. They arrive only to find Ponzu's blood and clothes on the ground. They discover a bullet made by NGL, but Kite and the others know that the massacre was done by the Chimera ants. Kite fears that the ants and NGL is the worst combination imaginable. As the Chimera ants continue their ravage throughout NGL, Gon, Killua, and Kite rush to the location of the nest, hoping to reach it before the king is born. Meanwhile, the Chimera ant queen demands over 100 humans per day to assure the king's growth. Even though he is initially surprised, Colt does not hesitate to comply with the queen's orders, although he rejects Turtle's idea to immediately increase the ranks. At that moment, Zazen appears to tell everyone about the capture of a rare human. After a short bicker between Zazen and Pike, and later Behorn and Pike, The Chimera Ants continue talking about rare humans and realize that the officers can see their Nen and disable them. Gon, Killua, and Kite arrive at a village to find it abandoned. However, Gon picks up something that smells, and upon reaching the location of the smell, they come across corpses of horses that were feasted on by Ramen. Suddenly, they are approached by Ramen himself while, unbeknownst to them, being watched by Colt from the forest. Ramen angrily claims the horses are for himself and charges towards the hunters. The boys are overwhelmed by his attack, but Kite effortlessly evades it and unleashes his Nen. He backs away and tells Gon and Killua to deal with the Chimera Ant soldier on their own in order to prove that they're able to face them. Gon and Killua step forward, unleashing their Nen. While Ramen notices a sudden difference in the boys' power, Gon and Killua tell Kite not to treat them like kids and attack Ramen. Even though the Chimera Ant seems to be overpowering them at first, Killua uses his lightning skill and casts a thunderbolt to immobilize Ramen, while Gon uses his own technique to blast the Chimera Ant away. Much to their surprise, Ramen is suddenly snatched away by Colt and the two escape as Ramen yells at the boys, wanting to eat them. Gon and Killua realize that their attacks didn't have much effect, however. Kite praises them and asks whether they want to come with him, receiving a positive answer from the boys. Meanwhile, at the nest, Ramit's anger is at its finest, wanting more than just simply killing Gon and Killua. He reveals to Colt that other squads have been killing humans and leaving their corpses there. Colt questions other squadron leaders about that, and Hagia simply states that it's fun. However, he promises to bring the rare ones to the queen. This turns out to be a lie, as Leol states that they will find a rare one and eat it. Meanwhile, Gon and the others find more corpses that were brutalized by the Chimera Ants. They reach a drug factory overtaken by the Chimera Ants and decide to look inside. Thank you for watching. Please remember to subscribe so you don't miss the next one. And give this video a like if you enjoyed it.